Hey guys, Colby here. Welcome back to another video. As you can see, my rock breaker there, last man standing, and on S19, I was trying to beat it, failed. Then I had another run, I believe, where I failed again. It's just horrible when you reach to that point after so many tries and you fail it. But eventually, I did manage to get the stage down. I'll show you guys the next run and go through a complete like walkthrough on my decision making and everything. So the idea is here to use double rock breaker, no reviver. Okay, the double rock breaker helps a ton here with the provokes, and then having a stun set on as many champions as possible is really the key. Although I didn't go with that route, I went with two stun sets as my whole team, and then I went with a bolster set on Steel Skull that helps with the initial hits, especially when you are trying to push through. So this is like one of the runs that I did yesterday when I was trying to beat it, and it's like the best case scenario. Okay, this is like when you stun both of the Taras so that your fourth board does not get stunned from the counterattack that they do. They counterattack with their A2 when my Rage Quit gets hit, which is very annoying, but that's how it works. Unfortunately though, even though I had like the perfect RNG, which is double stun on the Taras, I just couldn't beat it on this stage. I just wanted to show you guys like the best RNG possible that you can have. And I'll show you guys all the stats at the end for each champion's gears that I had equipped in order for you guys to replicate it if you wish to do so. So a big problem with no reviver, right, is it obviously, yeah, exactly that, the no reviver. You gotta be very careful when you get hit. If you do get hit, you gotta try and heal that champion that gets hit a lot. But sometimes, like if the big AoEs come through, you're screwed, right? There's no amount of healing that Steel Skull can do to just make everybody healthy again. He'll heal somebody, but somebody will be left with a lower amount of health, and he'll be targeted by the AI, the enemy AI, and you'll die. So this was like, okay, I could get through. I was trying to push through with this setup since I got the double stun at the start, which was like the perfect scenario. But sometimes like a resist will happen, sometimes a weak hit will happen, the stun set will not go through, and that's when you just die. Okay, rock breakers I found are very tanky here. Okay, these two are the key. Basically, you need these epics. You need the epics. I mean, they restrict so many things in these stages that you need the epics. There's no way around it. Not that it's not doable without one rock breaker. And I believe Scratch did it with Gnarlhorn because he didn't have a rock breaker, I believe. It's just that it's gonna be like impossible to do this with, just rares as an example. Just the damage that you need to get through the first part where Marichka is, you need a very strong damage dealer, and that's epics, all right? Especially if you have blessings on them. I only had a one-star blessing, which didn't help a lot. So let's go to the actual run where I do manage to take them out. I believe, is it this one? I think it's this one. But anyway, this goes very slow because of the fact that you just have one damage dealer, really. And that's Morag. And that's what I was trying to do. And this is like a part where, unfortunately, one of my rock breakers dies. I had to reset, and this happened throughout. I tried with revivers and stuff, but it just doesn't work as well, I want to say, because what I did here, guys, I gave a stun set on one of my rock breakers, and I found that that was key into just beating a little bit of the RNG. Since when he counterattacks, he still has that chance to stun. It's 18% chance. I didn't have masteries on them, on him. It was only one of the rock breakers with the stun set. The other was in reflex, so he can hopefully get his provoke through sooner. And that was the goal of the team, okay? So I was pushing through. The idea is to do like big damage on Marishka. Look at that resist there that happened on Morag. That was very lucky, actually. I'm not sure if this was the run. I still think was not the run, but I just wanted to show you all the different RNG parts that happen that make this so frustrating sometimes. Like Here I got my my Ford Bore. I managed to drop in two stuns there on the terrace, and then provoke happens. The good thing about the stuns on the terrace is that they do not counterattack you. And I was getting lucky refresh. I thought this was the run, but I still think that this was the failed run. Even so, the biggest problem actually is not Marishka and killing Marishka. It's actually Sethalia, because if she gets a turn, if she doesn't get controlled, she will destroy your run. She has the block debuffs that she can spread around, right? She could give it to somebody else. She fully heals. She reduces your Terminator. She's just very annoying. Very, very annoying. Look at that. She basically got a turn, and I think she screwed my run here because of that turn. And I had to reset, because, like, if you get hit, look at the amount of health I have. This is just no going back, right? Look at that. Full health there. I think I gave up here. And I thought, okay, this is going to be crazy RNG that I'll need to beat it. So this is like the actual final run, all right? Just showing you the RNG that I had to beat this. So stuns there happened, but I think it was fine with me. I just went with it, I think. And then just did my AoE. Look at that, 60K. Then I cleanse on Morag, so that she can go in with her ally attack skill. You'll see it right now. And the ally attack skill, if it does enough damage, gives an extra turn on Morag, but you get stunned by the terraces, so it doesn't matter here. Yeah, we get stunned there, and then the stun becomes one turn because she gets the extra turn. And the bad thing about the stuns is that you lose the cooldown, you know, reduction that you get when the turn goes through. But yeah, the Sethalia, you gotta take her down as quickly as possible and hopefully control her throughout the fight. Also, you gotta control everybody, really. There's no just letting them do their skills, because when you don't have a reviver, you're kind of screwed. Kind of screwed. And this is where things like proper gear sets come into play. Like, I had the Frostbite set, I had the stun sets, I had one bolster only, which helps a little bit with the shield at the start for three turns, and then some healing, like passive healing on Steel Skull. And Steel Skull was quite fast, I believe 280 speed, which I'll show everything in the end, don't worry about that. I'll try to put some chapters down below so that you guys can see how I've separated the video. Maybe this will help you through this rotation, maybe the next one. It honestly is RNG heavy, which I don't like. I don't like it being so RNG heavy, but it's still like, I mean, how else would they do a challenge like so with waves? If it's not a boss and it's waves, they just put in champions in there. One thing that I could think of is that they could do something in the future where they add champions in there in the waves with specific sets on them. So like a stun set on a champion, on the enemy champions, like an immunity set. That's kind of like an extra challenge, but then allow us to use more champions instead of restricting us to just epics and stuff. Anyway, that's maybe for another video. Ideas for another video. So here, trying to recover everybody's health, okay? Trying to recover everybody's cooldowns only once I start killing stuff. Because right now, I'm not really worried about my cooldowns. I just want to get through this part and also keep Ford Boar alive. That dude is very, very crucial to beating this. Honestly, you need the defense down and the guaranteed stun. Talking about guarantee, look at that resist. Beautiful. I mean, it happens. It happens. It depends on your gear, but if you can hit like 360 on accuracy, you're gonna get, you're gonna have a bad time. So here you see they push through with their cooldowns, buffs removed, stuns through. It just gets messy, right? It gets messy. And when you don't have a reviver, you gotta be very careful on who you are stunning. Like, you have to take a look at their Terminator and be like, okay, this one's taking a turn. He's stunned, so he's gonna lose the turn. Maybe I'll go for the other target. It just cycle like that. But I think Rock Breaker and Fortboard with the stun said, we're enough. I think Scratch used like a stun set on his Steel Skull. Maybe his other support also had a stun set. I didn't feel the need to have stun set on everybody. Other guys from the ET clan who beat it gave me some advice. And I try to follow through with everybody. So thanks, by the way, everybody for that. And then I went my own way with the stun set on the one Rock Breaker, because I thought that would be kind of clutch when it happens because of the counterattacks. Because you're provoking them, right? They're attacking you. You attack them back. There's an 80% chance. If the stun goes through, it's beautiful. Like here, you see, I provoke them even with so little health because I just don't want to risk it. Look at my Morag. Like she was like 2 bars health. It's just crazy to think I would get so far, like 5 minutes in the run, and then have to restart again because it was getting late. I'm also a bit sick, that's why there's no video today. I mean, no camera. I'm a bit sick. It just my throat feels horrible, coughing all the time. But it's gonna get better anyway. Beat the stage one. Stage two now comes in where it's very difficult. But it was like everything aligned for me this time around because I tried this multiple times. You gotta beat Sylphurion. You gotta beat him as soon as possible. But when you have double provoke, you have 2 turns of basically being able to do anything on them. And when you land the defense down on them, you're good to go because Morag will do enough damage with like 5,000 defense, 250 crit damage in a Savage. She'll do it, right? You do need masteries though. I would say Helm Smasher when it procs, it helps to go through even more of that defense. And then I kill Sylphurion, and then you gotta kill the two the crocodiles, because when they hit you, they decrease your accuracy permanently, I believe. Although I don't think it matters for the next round. I think it matters for this round, and if you lose too much accuracy, you're in trouble for the two pasadas, okay? These two guys, they hit like I'm not gonna say paper, but almost like paper in the real world. But when Flareon makes a stage and they give them like thousands of base stats, just like that, even a single turn by them can be wrecking. So those two have to be controlled or killed immediately. And this round was very lucky for me because I had provokes, I had the reflex set proccing, the reaction set proccing, I believe, one time as well. And what I was trying to do is just control, okay? Here I do the stun, I believe. No, defense down. I can't remember exactly what I did, but there we go. The other Basada will take a turn now. This will hurt. Oh, there's a provoke. Okay, he eventually gets a turn, and you'll see how much damage he does. He gets a turn even without all the buffs that he can get from the crocodiles. All right, those crocs can give him some solid buffs. They apply debuffs, they apply buffs on themselves. It get nuts. Okay, I think it's here where he gets a turn, and it's crazy. No, it's even a little bit later. I think I was trying to save all my cooldowns, and that's why he got a turn. That's what I think happened. So there we go. We kill the one, only one left standing, and just trying to recover all my cooldowns as well. I have my defense down, my AoE attack, my ally attack, everything. So here, didn't like use my A3. Didn't even use my defense up here because I didn't wanna not have it for Morag on the next round, because that is basically like a boost of damage. So here, look at that. Yeah, I got resisted and then provoked. So basically, my provokes were in trouble. My cooldowns. This goes on for like another 30 seconds because I believe he heals. It gets very stupid. He puts a healing over time. Yeah, that's what he does. Doesn't heal. Was it on this run? I remember that he gets through and actually does lots of damage on me. Even so, it's just, yeah, I think it's here. Yeah, look at this. Look at this. He had like 1% health. He went through and did half my health damage, even on Rockbreakers. It was crazy. So here is the surprise part. With Jingwon being immune to provokes, I was kind of screwed. So I needed a stun here to land, which didn't land on anybody. If one stun lands, then he would use his passive and this would have been more smooth with the provokes. But I didn't get lucky. I got mad at that when I saw it. Like no stuns. I had such a perfect run. Everybody surviving full health, almost all their cooldowns. It's just no stun. That 25%, 24% didn't just work. 23%, yeah. And I was so mad, but I thought, okay, I'll do my best and see how this does. At least I have the defense down on them. I'll try to push through with the provoke. I'll know it's going to get cleansed, but I'll eventually get it. So I was just left there. I wasn't doing anything. I was just looking at my screen thinking, okay, what do I do now? I thought, okay, might as well do the provoke. No actual cleanse happens. It's only cleanse of the provoke. So that was good. That's what I was trying to think. Then I did my AoE and with the defense down, this helps so much. I had the refresh there, but that doesn't matter because Yumiko comes in next and she does her lock skill. My Morag there counterattacks. And that is pretty, pretty cool. Because of the defensive masters, right? So at this point, when I take one down and then I see the stun from Fodbor, I think this is done. This is over. The most amazing run in terms of RNG, I would say, with probably wave two. Wave two went a little bit more smooth than I expected. Wave three, I could have had even better RNG. But as you can see, if you can get to this point where even Jingwon dies, you're pretty okay. I expected the Harimas to hit way harder. But the good thing is that they didn't actually build them like real players built Harimas. Because real players make the Harimas tanky as hell. They nuke really hard. And at least it wasn't like that. So this takes me like another minute to beat it, another 30 turns or so. I wasn't worried about the turn count at all. I don't care about that. I don't have the capacity to care about that the time, but it's still interesting that, you know, it was an interesting encounter. I won't say it was fun because it was a lot of repeats. I want to say it took me like a good 2 hours of just RNG, switching gear, lots of silver, lost count, gems used for masteries on Fodbor and Morag. So, I mean, that's 1600 gems. I could have done Minotaur, but I wanted to get it done today and, like, you know, get some content out on this, the hardest stage ever. So there it is, 1229, 269 turns. That's how I beat it with Morag 1.5 million almost, and, you know, 100k from Rockbreakers and Fodbors and Steel Skulls. Basically zero damage from them. It's only Morag, but only one star blessing, really. Which barely does anything. It's just the first hit of the round. So guys, let me just show you the gear to finish this off. I did move some pieces from my, you know, my good champions, but this is Rockbreaker number one, the one with the 2-star. It's got a reflex and a frostbite. Frostbite helps 10% chance to place a freeze on the attacker. In terms of overall stats, 58,000 health, 4,000 defense, 246 speed, 393 accuracy. A little bit of accuracy there on my chest piece from Ascension. I had attack percent here. I was trying to roll this into speed, re-roll it into speed. I just didn't have the materials. It's just so hard to farm them. Takes thousands upon thousands of energy. And I was trying to get speed, accuracy, and defensive stats where I could, but my reflex sets kind of suck. So I used reaction also, refresh also, and whatever I had, I used basically that 10% chance together to prevent skill cooldown. If it procs, it's nice. Basically no masteries. I only went for defense and then decrease damage received if he gets a stun, which I don't get often stunned on Rockbreaker because I wasn't trying to hit the Taraz. Maybe rejuvenation would have been better. And then I also went for the extra accuracy for each enemy alive. I feel that that is very crucial in Exalted Death. Charge focus, I believe, are also crucial since he's got one skill only, right? So that's my one Rockbreaker. Number two Rockbreaker was in a stun set and a perception set. Just use 5-star gear if I had. It really depends on the stats I had. Defense percent, running like a 4.4 defense, 1000 defense, 48,000 health, 250 speed, 391 accuracy here. And then just as you can see, like my gear isn't really amazing. Here it's just double on speed. Here double on speed, crit rate, crit damage. I mean, that's not what you want to have on Rockbreaker for this specific run, but that's what I had with double roll on speed. My stun set, it's kind of crap. And like even my banner, it's a one rolled on accuracy. I didn't want to move gear from my Geomancers and stuff, although I could have done it. I was running low on silver. I had like 15 million left. And if I want to do the other stages, I'll need to farm spider. I was trying to think of that. And I was like, crap, I got to spend... Gotta spend lots of my resources for this, crazy. But I think it's a necessary evil after a while. I even moved some gear from my Sifi, honestly. So it's not like I wasn't having like really good gear on. I had a chest piece on Morag here from Sifi, which gave her lots of speed and defense. So I think I can show you guys. I think it was this chest piece right here. With like 30 speed, crit rate, crit damage, defense percent there. So that was like very nice on Morag. So overall stats were about 250 speed, 100% crit, 250 crit damage, with way higher defense than that, like 5.4, I want to say. No resist, no accuracy needed. With, of course, double refresh here. Even this one had the good ascension on it. Was taken from my other damage dealers. I had masteries on her. King Hell Smasher is crucial. Retribution is also very nice. Oh, I didn't have deterrence, but deterrence can also be very cool because if somebody gets done, she would counterattack with that. Maybe I should have taken that instead of methodical now that I think about it, but whatever. It worked. It worked. Of course, you want to max her out in the Crushing Rain if you have it. It's very nice. I actually got it today. The 1-star blessing from the market for 20 immortal stones or whatever those are called. The first hit ignores 1% for 50 levels. They're like, what, level 300? So, what, 6%? Not that much, but it's still something, right? So that was Morag, really. She was key here in terms of damage. And then Steel Skull. He also had a glove here with speed from Sifi, which I gave it back after I beat it. He was about 280, 290, I believe, speed with higher health and higher defense. Not that those really matter. He was the one never getting attacked, single target attack. He's there basically to be fast and be like an ambulance to heal with his A2 and A3, right? Masteries, I had them from... I mean, this guy is an OG. Steel Skull's an OG. Old players, veteran players will have him with masteries already. You don't need the masteries, I will say. The War Master does like 1,000 damage when it procs. Don't go with masteries. And I could have done better masteries if I really wanted to. Probably Bulwark if I really wanted to make him like a more proper support and better healing. But... whatever, I didn't change his masteries. And then finally, Fort Boar with a stun set. And at perception set, 258 was the second fastest in my team, actually. 47,000 health, 2.5 defense was very squishy, I found. 386 accuracy. Maxed out skills, of course. And then finally, with masteries, Fearsome Presence works so nice with his stun set. So kind of need that. And also, Master Hexer can be nice to extend the duration of his defense down that he applies, right? So overall, I think fun challenge. I'll be trying to tackle the other stages in maybe today. I don't know if I'll do it live. I wanted to do it live, but honestly, I'm feeling very sick, guys. And I just I don't have the... I cough all the time. It would be nasty, right? So I tried other champions. Tried Gnarlhorn with this set, as you can see. Frostbite set, triple refresh. Gnarlhorn, when he gets hit, he just gets hit by a ton of damage. It's crazy how much tankier Rockbreaker is because of their passive, right? Because they decrease the damage inflicted on them, 50% chance, plus increased defense when they do their A1. But it's doable with Gnarlhorn. It's doable. I mean, it's been done already, so I'm not saying it's not doable. I also tried Melga a little bit with the stun set. It was nice to have the revive, but I was very much depending on stuns to control the wave. And it was very RNG heavy. I spent most of my time using the Melga strategy, and that's why I've wasted like a good hour with Melga. Where I think with the Rockbreakers, it was way smoother. If you have double provoke, it will be way smoother. It's just the problem with Gnarlhorn is that he is squishier, okay? His cooldown is also 3 turns. He also gets an increased defense, but he is squishier, like 60,000 health, 2,000 defense. Like, I could try change things through, get his defense higher, but he's still squishy. And I was trying to get his accuracy high. It just gets very tough. Maybe the frost set was the worst decision because I have like 4 pieces of frost. But this was like not even day one. It was like the first 20 minutes of trying to beat this. I thought, okay, Gnarlhorn, I got him on 4 stars. The blessing is going to help a little bit with taking damage from, you know, multi-hit skills and stuff. He's going to be a little bit tankier. And then I thought, wait a minute, I've got the Rockbreakers. Why am I not using them? I leveled them to 60, booked them up, but I didn't go with full masteries. And that's how I did it, guys. Thank you all if you watched this far. I hope it's helpful for you guys. I don't know what the next rotation is going to be, but it sure is going to be difficult. Thank you all. I appreciate your support. If you do want to support me, click that subscribe and the like button on your way out. Thank you all. I'll see you in the next one. See ya.